typical country outlet.
I wanted to please my parents and my teachers and please God. If that standard was up here, I felt like all of my best efforts were only getting to here. I would try and try, but I could not live up to what God called me to do. I was becoming so discouraged that I could not be all that God wanted me. I could not be righteous on my own, and I was discouraged by that. And one day, I was in church, and my pastor was preaching. And he challenged us just to surrender our lives to the
Lord.
And I knew at that moment that God was speaking to my heart. After the service, he invited people to come to the front for prayer. And as I stood there and prayed, the Holy Spirit came into my life in a very powerful
way.
I had been striving so hard to live for God. But I knew in that moment, as I surrendered myself fully to Him, that He had given His righteousness to me. When the Holy Spirit comes to live inside of us, He makes us holy, just as God the Father is holy. The Holy Spirit is such a great gift because He makes us new. So the Holy Spirit is our closest companion. He makes us new. There's a third reason the Holy Spirit is such a great gift. He gives us power to fulfill the mission. There was a time when the disciples were very afraid. Peter was so afraid of being identified with Jesus that he lied to a little girl and said he never knew Jesus. And then we read that after Jesus had died, they were all in the room together and they had all the doors locked. They were afraid what would happen to them. But then something changed. We read in Acts chapter 2 that the Holy Spirit came and filled the disciples. We call this the day of Pentecost. It's the day that the church began. And this little group of Jesus followers who had been so scared before went outside in the temple to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ. Because the Holy Spirit filled them, everything changed. new fourth admission. And creates authentic community.
So they join in community.
In which each person can be unleashed. Through the empowerment of the Holy Spirit. To fulfill God's creational intentions. There are things that God wants to do in this room. There are things that God wants to use your church to do in reaching Myanmar. In reaching the other states of India. And in reaching the world. And when we hear what God's plans are for us, we can say, but we are so small and we are so few. And that's why the Bible says, not by might, not by power, but by my spirit, says the Lord. As we close the service today, I'd like to invite you to stand. Let's pray together that the Holy Spirit would fill us afresh. Let's all lift our voices to the Lord. Let's all pray together.
yang sebesar kita kumpulkan itu dan bagian yang kita kumpulkan tapi pun sombong itu cuma lelah sombong yang kita kumpulkan
Amen.